right.
Thank you.
Thank you. Good morning. We welcome you back to the Lakeland Center for the 2012 FHSAA Boys Basketball Finals, our final day of the Boys Basketball Finals this year, 2012. And it's time for our first of four state championship games today. First in Class 5A, the Jacksonville Terry Parker Braves with a record of 25-5, the Lake Wales Highlanders, who are 27-4. Marty Pullman back courtside at the Lakeland Center here in Lakeland, and joined by the head girls basketball coach at Northeast High School in St. Petersburg, Will White. As we will crown four more state champions today. We've already had four earlier this week. Chipley in 1A, Orlando Christian Prep in 2A. Tampa Prep, Joe Finland winning his first state title after 29 years and eight trips here to Lakeland in 3A and in 4A. It was Pinecrest once again out of Fort Lauderdale winning the state title. First today though, 5A, Lake Wales, a team from right here in Polk County, bringing a pretty good contingent for this 10 a.m. start. And they'll face a team, the Terry Parker Braves, that was able to get past Nature Coast in the semifinals. Actually, it was a two-point game with about 6 minutes to go, but a technical against Nature Coast and really set Terry Parker on the way. They pulled away to win by 26, and Lake Wales also cruised in their semifinal over Plantation American Heritage, 75-44. Your starting lineup for Lake Wales, number 0, a 6'5 senior forward, Lamar Welch. Number 5'6'5 senior guard, Alante Finner. Number 11, a 6 foot senior guard, Russell Wilson. Number 13, a 6'5 senior forward, Marcel White. And number 15, a 6'5 senior center, Antoine Hadley. Lake Wales is coached by Billy Washington. They were finalists a year ago in the 5A state championship game, lost to Palm Beach Gardens Dwyer 72-57. And your starting lineup for the Terry Parker Braves, number 3, a 5'11 senior guard, Ricardo Harris. Number 4, 6'3 senior guard, Keith Williams. Number 13, 6'5 senior forward, Chris Chernet. Number 22, a 6'3 senior forward, Joshua Parks. And number 44, 6'3 junior forward, Lamar Seymour. And Terry Parker, coached by Elijah Wells. So, Coach, welcome back to Lakeland. Good to be with you. And again, another exciting day of basketball, because again, state champions will be crowned today. That's always a lot of fun in this first game. Lake Wales, not only considered the number one team in the state in 5A, according to SourceHoops.com, maybe one of the top teams in the country as well.
Yeah, Max Preps has them rated number 35 in the country. So anytime you start getting to that kind of ranking, you know, you're going to have a phenomenal team. And they just kind of get everything started with their defense.
Now, their only state championship for Lake Wales came in 2000. Again, they were state finalists a year ago. Yeah, lost to Dwyer. It was obviously another nationally ranked Dwyer team who had a lot of talent. So Lake Wales has made it back here. On the other side, Terry Parker, last in the semifinals way back in 1990, their last state championship, 1967. And a reminder, you win a DVD of this state championship game or any game in the 2012 FHSAA Boys Basketball Finals. Go to FHSAASports.com. That's FHSAASports.com. And Terry Parker under Elijah Wells, his 16th year. He's had a lot of struggles in his career at Parker, but he's got himself a good team the last 3 years, really put it together, and this year all the way to the state championship game.
Yeah, you know, I didn't start out, you know, they're not like a traditional powerhouse, which I like to see here sometimes. You kind of start seeing the same names kind of again and again, but they've definitely had a nice run of it here, and should be a really good game here.
One of the big stories today for Terry Parker is they're able to get back their leading scorer, their 6'1 junior guard, Solomon Poole. He was ejected from two games this season. The second came on January 20th against Bishop Kenny. At that point, he had to serve a 6-week suspension. Well, that ended yesterday. So the good news for Terry Parker is they won Thursday night. They got a day off for the final, so they're able to get him back. We don't know if he's going to play. He's not starting.
Yeah.
But at least they'll have that, you know, availability of their top scorer during the season.
Yeah, that's an interesting position to put Coach Wells in. The team's obviously done well without him. They got a nice chemistry going on. So how much do you play him and mess up kind of what's been going on? But it is one of your better players. So, you know, that's why they get paid the big bucks, you know, trying to determine that situation right there of, you know, bringing in one of your better players but messing up kind of what got you here.
Well, Terry Parker's road to Lakeland, they defeated Nice 74-49, Ponte Vedra 65-59 in overtime. And then they won at Ponte Vedra, won at Springfield Rutherford by 5-64-59. They were the winners of District 3 and Region 1. Lake Wales, well, they've rolled through the region. Region 3, they beat Merritt Island by 44. They beat Rockledge by 33. They beat Jesuit by 41. In the state semifinal, they beat American Heritage by 31. So their closest game was 31 points in the playoffs. That was Thursday night, and that had a running clock in the second half.
Yeah, sometimes, you know, if you haven't been in a tight game, that could be a bad thing, you know. So if it's close, you know, that's definitely going to be a disadvantage. Another thing really jumps out at me here, Keith Williams from Terry Parker, his dad won a state championship while he was at Rains, and his brother won 4 state championships at Arlington Country Days. So there's kind of some blood going on here and some bragging rights within the family, a dinner table to be able to say, well, I got mine. Right. Being a senior, this is his last chance.
Arlington Country Day won 5 straight state titles in the mid-2000s at one point. No longer a member of the FHSAA school in Jacksonville. Lake Wales will wear the black uniforms, the orange and white stripes, the orange letters and numerals of white trim. Terry Parker wearing the white uniforms with the navy blue to black letters and numerals with the red trim, red and white stripes. Are underway as Jornette jumping against Hadley, and Lake Wales wins the opening tip. This is Russell Wilson to run the point, and we're underway in our first of 4 state championship games today from the Lakeland Center here on the FHSAA Network. And we'll have a five-second call on Russell Wilson to start the game.
Yeah, that's a good call. It doesn't seem like that gets called very often. And, you know, you got to give the defense credit. If they're close to the guard, the rule is 6 feet. So as long as you're within 6 feet, you got 5 seconds to do something with it.
So it is Terry Parker ball to start. This is Ricardo Harris to run the point. Welcome back to our new courtside camera today. Great angle here from the FHSAA basketball finals is Keith Williams. Dribbling now to the right wing. Now top of the key, this is Joshua Parks. Over to Ricardo Harris. Hardest will now dribble back out. Off to Williams. Keith Williams, the leading scorer in the absence of Solomon Poole on this team. Lamar Seymour had it now driving in. The floater no good. The putback by Seymour. He's fouled as Harris missed a shot, but Seymour's fouled. And Lamar Seymour will shoot two on the first foul of the game going against Lake Wales.
And Coach Washington for Lake Wales says his defense is kind of predicated on, you know, pressure everywhere. And it really, he said that it gives Russell Wilson lots of the credit for setting the tone on the defense. They already started in like a diamond press back into a real tough half-court man looking to trap if they get a chance at it.
Seymour short on the free throw as our referees today for the Mid-Coastal Officials Association in Brevard County. Larry Torcha, the head referee, Calvin Ryan, and John Abrams are our officials for this championship game. But Seymour missed both, in and out on the free throw, and we're still scoreless less than a minute into the state championship game.
Yeah, people often forget this is a state championship for the officials as well. You know, this is something they've worked hard for, get a chance to come out here and kind of show off.
And there's Finner for three at the top of the key. Lake Wales 6-3 on the lead. And officials, I guess, get her based on their work during the season. I'm sure they're graded as well as the drive. Oh, rejected underneath by Marcel White. Harris had it blocked away. Here's Wilson the other way. And he will hand it off to a drive. No shot, no good by Finner. And the ball out of bounds will stay with Lake Wales. And Lake Wales now off to a flying start.
Yeah, Lake Wales is definitely a momentum team. So if I was Coach Wells for Terry Parker, don't be afraid to use timeouts if you need it. Just kind of something that you're thinking as the game goes on. You definitely don't want it to get out of hand. You have these media timeouts that'll help as well.
Hadley underneath to a shot good by White. He had his first shot blocked, but White gets the follow, lays it in. Marcel White, he's the leading scorer for Lake Wales, getting a lot of looks from colleges. As Lake Wales starts five seniors, all five starters are seniors. Drive up, no good there by Keith Williams. Terry Parker, four of their starters are seniors. A junior, the other starter, is a both teams very senior experienced. That's one of the reasons why they're here at this level.
You see that a lot more at the higher classifications. The lower classifications, you tend to have a few more underclassmen being able to participate.
And Wilson drives in. He's fouled. That'll be the first foul on Terry Parker. Russell Wilson will shoot two free throws. And that foul goes on Ricardo Harris, his first.
Two shots for Wilson.
He's a 65% free throw shooter. Lake Wells is kind of in a faux press right now, we'd call it, like a fake press. It's really more man. So as long as you just want to get the ball in, clear it out, and then you can push the ball forward.
Free throw is short, and neither team has made a free throw yet. A second free throw coming up for Wilson, the senior. And this time he nails it, so 1-for-2 for Wilson, his first point, and it's a 6-0 lead for the Highlanders. We're 2 minutes into this championship game. Again, a little bit of pressure, and then almost taken away by Wilson. Seymour comes up with it. Fans wanted to travel as Joshua Parks goes inside and loses it. Steal again, Lake Wales on the run. And Marcel White double dribble.
As good as Lake Wales is at basketball, you think that they'd have a lot of basketball scholarships, but in fact, they really have a lot more football players on their team. Three have already signed a letter of intent to play college football.
As Elijah Wells takes the timeout, Terry Parker uses the timeout as Coach Wells tries to settle his team down. They did get a turnover there, but they're down 6-0 early and having some trouble with the pressure of Lake Wales. And also Lake Wales, again, able to move up and down the court there. Very fluid team, and they have an early lead. And you mentioned three of their players going to sign letters of intent in college, Lamar Welch, Antoine Hadley, and LaDarren Wilson.
And they got another guy, Cedric Christian, who's being pursued by some colleges to run track and field. So athletic and strong.
And there are nine players coming back from last year's state runner-up team. Talk about a team that's got to be focused. You make it all the way here, you bring back that whole team. You know, from the beginning, that's the goal to get to this point.
Yeah, especially losing that one. So, you know, they definitely, you know, want to go out with a bang.
Now Harris over to Jornet. Inside to Harris. Harris lost it, though. Seymour will pick it up in the corner. And then out to Williams, who almost lost it. Now he picks it back up, drives near the top of the key. not the free throw line. This is Joshua Parks. He'll drive in, his left-handed shot blocked, and a rebound to Lake Wales.
Yeah, Lake Wales can definitely get out after you. They were up 23-8 yesterday in the first quarter.
Easy pass inside, and Hadley with an easy hook with a right-handed hook. It's 8-0 Lake Wales on the assist from Wilson that time.
Yeah, they're not really doing anything super special. They're just playing really tough half-court, man. You watch them here. They're going to fight through every screen, kind of bump you a little bit on your drives.
That was a three for Jernet. It's short. Run out again for Lake Wales. Here comes Penner underneath. Easy layup for Hadley. Terry Parker better be careful here. They're already down 10.
And you see here, Coach Wells putting in Poole.
So Solomon Poole will see some action. And I guess at this point down 10, you need to get some more offense in there. Knocked away. Ends up in the hands of Parks, who drives in, draws the foul. Can't get the shot to go. But we'll have Joshua Parks shooting two, and that will bring in the junior Solomon Poole. Has the foul.
Yeah, you couldn't wait much longer there. If you decided that you're going to play him and put him in there, you know, you're down 10-0. So maybe he is, like you said before the game, that spark that maybe they're going to need to kind of get going. Because right now they have zero going on.
Well, at the line, a free throw getting missed by Parks. Terry Parker 0-3 from the line. And Solomon Poole will come back in. He'll replace Chris Jernet. Poole is a junior, so he'll return to the Terry Parker team. He played his freshman year at Providence School. Actually, he was on the state champion team along with his brother, Stacy Jr., who started at Kentucky, is now transferred to Georgia Tech. Of course, his father was a star guard at University of Florida in the early 90s out of Forest High School in Jacksonville. So the first point for Parker, and we'll have an offensive foul. I think Poole actually was able to draw the offensive foul as Hadley picks up his second foul, actually. That's two quick fouls in Antoine Hadley, third team foul for Lake Wales.
Yeah, the tone's going to be set here with the officials a little bit. Lake Wales is just, they're really up on you, and they're kind of checking you a little bit, and so it just depends on how much they're going to let them get away with.
So here's Ricardo Harris to run the point across that court. Douglas Brooks on him, and then he threw it away. Seymour tried to save it. It's saved by Brooks instead. Lake Wales on the run. Wilson had it knocked away, then gets it back, and somehow got it to Marcel White, who laid it in, or dunked it. Looks like Wilson was going to lose the ball, and he somehow was able to get it past the White. And now a steal again by Wilson.
That's a golden rule. You never go between your legs or between the back when you're being double-teamed.
Three-pointer is short by Finner. We're going to have a foul over the – nope, we have Parker with a foul on the rebound. And it's 12-1 now. The foul on Seymour. That's his first second team foul. Again, Terry Parker having trouble getting the ball past half court.
Coach Wells over there asking if this should be the media timeout, but it's
right at four.
Yeah, we'll fix that here, but it's right at four, so they get the next dead ball.
And there's another three. The corner good for Douglas Brooks. He had a big game off the bench in the semifinals. It's 15-1. Here's Poole quickly. Has it taken to going again by Wilson?
He looks very rusty so far.
And Finner had it knocked. Oh, and Poole knocks down the cameraman for Bright House Sports. Oh, my goodness. And I don't think there's anything intentional there, but we saw him. And
yeah, it's just one of those things. We've got a lot of momentum going. And these kids aren't used to, obviously, people being around under the basket very often, whatever. It's not like college or pro, so that was just incidental.
Solomon Poole picks up his first foul, and you're right, he looks very rusty. Got to wonder how long he'll stay in the game as the free throw no good for Finner. And Poole Raven right now is struggling getting the ball past half court. And Terry Parker, Lake Wales is just wreaking havoc.
Yeah, Poole's tried to go behind his back the last couple times in the double team. You just can't do that. If you're a little rusty, it's easier if you're like post player to get into your groove. But if you're a point guard trying to get into it, it's a little bit tougher. In fact, they even got him all the way back now, let somebody else bring the ball up, because he was struggling.
Second free throw no good as well, 0 for 2 there, so Finner misses both. Both teams with three team fouls. And again, this is Ricardo Harris across the timeline. Boy, Wilson right on it. Oh, that's Brooks, pardon me. Wilson underneath the Seymour lays it in, draws the foul off the assist.
Oh,
a travel. Didn't see that, but the call is made. And we have a media timeout. It is all Lake Wales as that basket didn't count for Terry Parker. 3:25 to go first quarter. It's 15-1. Lake Wales leads it. Marty Palman along with Coach Will White. And Coach, welcome back. I know you're the girls coach at Northeast High School, your first season. And spent some time at Boca Ciega and Gulfport and St. Pete. You know this arena well, as getting here three times in a row with your girls' team there.
Yeah,
Boca Ciega.
Yeah, we came here three times in a row, and I came once when I was helping out with the boys. So, you know, this is such a special venue for everybody to come to. You know, you get the community involved, the school involved, people coming out here yelling and screaming. And so it's fun as a coach as well, but it's also just it's really nice to kind of see your school and your community come together. It's a special experience.
And the boys program there has won, I believe, three or four state.
Three. I think the boys have just won. They've won two.
Two, okay. I thought they were they had won three or they won two in a row, in fact.
No, the girls won two in a row, like 94, 95.
That's right, sorry.
And the boys won in the late 80s. They had an All-American named David White, whose daughter is an eighth grader, who's about ready to come into Pinellas and kind of step up a little bit. And then Coach Schumann won a state championship, I believe it was 94.
Okay.
Had a really good, solid team. Darren Howard played on that team, who played in the NFL for the Saints as a defensive end. So, you know, Pinellas getting some love.
I always hear a lot of these football players playing basketball. We see that a lot as Wilson, or Brooks Wilson, actually drives in, misses a shot on the baseline, a foul, though, on Parker. And
yeah, that's the part that jumps out at me with Lake Wells is, you know, being number 35-ranked basketball team in the country, number one in 5A, and really their better players are going to be football players and track players. So if you watch them play, it kind of comes across like that. It's just real tough, tenacious, in your face, and let's just use our speed and go.
Jaquavion Williams, who's coming off the bench, hits the free throw. The foul is on Patrick Baker, his first, fourth team foul on Parker. The free throw makes it a 16-1 lead as Lake Wales is 6 of 9, 67%. Already four steals. They forced five turnovers and five assists on the Lake Wales end. Only two turnovers as Williams hits both. It's 17-1.
Terry Parker's only attempted five shots, you know, so that's about a shot a minute. That's just not going to get it done.
Poole will run the point this time. And on him is Russell Wilson. Wilson really has quick hands. We've seen early. Poole will try a long three. That's an air ball. Not a very good shot for someone who's coming off 6-week absence. And now it'll be cross-court pass to Wilson.
Yeah, that's a real interesting dynamic because, you know, you've been sitting for so long. You're down, so you do want to make something happen, but you're kind of just playing a little outside of yourself.
Wilson missed the shot. Now to Brooks. He'll try a three right corner. It's in and out, no good. And the rebound to Seymour. Brooks took it away. I think Wales is quicker right now.
Yeah.
Brooks though missed a shot and we'll have a foul coming up on the Parker Braves. And you're seeing right now Lake Wales, they're a very good team and they're playing like it.
Yeah, here's one of those things you pay attention. I know why Coach Wells is getting on the official there a little bit. If you ever watch a game and you see an official with an open hand, that means it's just out of bounds, dead ball traveling. Or a fist is a foul. So right there he had an open hand and then he closed his hand to call a foul.
Actually, they called a foul on Lake Wells.
Yeah, well, then you're happy.
If you're Coach Wells. But unfortunately, the score doesn't make you very happy. Williams picks up his first foul, fourth team foul, and looked like they had called the foul on Parker. It's Parker ball still looking for their first field goal. We're almost 5 minutes in. Another steal by Brooks. Brooks and Wilson really were quick hands. They are all over the ball.
I was going to point out the exact same thing because it looks like Terry Parker's having to start their half court, their offense at half court because Wilson is just playing
such
good defense. Oh, turnover, Coach White.
You had it, though. You knocked it down.
Got to grab that and chin it.
Our guy John here on the camera couldn't see that one. It's coming right at him. Luckily, he wasn't where Solomon Poole was earlier.
Oh, yeah. Been flying over the table. We've got to be paying attention here. But, yeah, Lake Wells said that their defense has started with Wilson up top, and you can kind of see that here at half court playing such tough man defense. It's hard to get set into an offense if you're setting it up there at half court.
Wilson almost had another steal. Harris is in trouble right now. And then taken away again by Wilson. Wilson on a run out, and he lays it in. Just too easy right now for Lake Wales.
That's tough. They just work so hard. And, again, if you can't get set into any sort of offense, you're just going to struggle like you are here.
Now Parker beats it across half court. Hoy to Seymour. Seymour going to try a three. Hit it. Amar Seymour gets the first basket of the game for Parker, and it's 19-4. Now Wilson will slow it down a bit, a minute and a half to go here in the first quarter. Now he'll speed up. Back out to Brooks, three again. It's short. And the defender has faced Michael Hoy, but another rebound for White. Marcel White now out to Finner. Finner with the alley-oop. This is the layup, though, is Williams, and then Williams gets a second chance, and he's fouled. Two free throws coming up for Jaquavion Williams. 15 foul on the Parker Braves, and the foul on Joshua Parks is his first.
And Coach Wells there asking for a travel, but one of the misnomers is if you try to shoot the ball, even if it's an air ball, you can go get it. It's not a travel. At the park, If you're playing down at the street, they always call that a self-pass travel, but it's not
self-pass,
a travel.
Self-pass, yeah. This free throw is in and out for Williams. You don't have to worry about that being called, right?
Right, exactly.
I'll have another free throw for Williams. As I tell you, Ely, Palmetto Beach Ely, is probably the best team in the state. Lake Wales is very close.
Oh, I'd love to see that matchup.
As the second free throw, in and out, no good. Ely will play for the 7A championship this afternoon, though, against Orlando Oak Ridge, who beat Oviedo. Great game yesterday between Oak Ridge and Oviedo. And Ely cruised. They had a running clock in the second half against St. Petersburg. As Jornet lays it in, and he draws the foul. Chris Jornet with a chance for a three-point play.
Yeah, if you get a running clock at the Final Four, that just kind of, I think it says more about the team that's up 35 than does the other team. It just shows you just how good you are, because you don't make it that far, even if it's maybe a down region or something, you don't make it to a Final Four without being a phenomenal team. So I think it says more about the team that's just a superb, just a different level.
Jornet misses the free throw, though. We have a minute to go. Closing in on a minute to go first quarter. It's 19-6. Wilson will drive in. That was too easy again. Boy, the defense cleared out, and Wilson had an open lane. He laid it in. He has five. 21-6. It's a 15-point lead for Lake Wales. First quarter of this 5A state championship game. Harris across half court. Again with Wilson on him. Boy, Wilson is bothering Harris. Harris gets away, though, to Seymour. Seymour will try a two left wing. He hits him. He's got a nice-looking jumper for a forward.
We're thinking the same things. Yeah, the last two shots when he's got his feet behind him. Yeah, you're right. When he's open, he's got a nice, smooth stroke.
Wilson hounded by Seymour. Now out to LaDarren Wilson. Now three for Brooks is short. Tip loose ball rebound ends up in the hands of Jornetta. You notice Poole not on the floor. Terry Parker's gone a little bit of a run here late in the first quarter.
Yeah, he looked a little too rusty and trying to do a little too much.
Here comes Harris all the way down the lane. Shot blocked down by Brooks. 5 seconds to go. Here comes Lake Wales quickly with two, with one. Russell Wilson will try a three at half court. That's an air ball. And that'll bring us to the end of the first quarter. And Lake Wales dominates the first period of this 5A state championship game. Our score, it's Lake Wales 21 and Terry Parker 8. Marty Palmer and Will White with you from the Lakeland Center in this 5A state championship game. We'll take a break and come back to the Lakeland Center in just a moment. You're watching the 2012 FHSAA Boys Basketball Finals on the FHSAA Network.
Get a player up here.
Oh, that's good stuff.
All right, perfect. Prepare a Wiley Ballard graphic.
Do you want me to start the stream?
Start the stream. Camera three. Beautiful. We're coming in on one.
For more information on how your school can join the Play On School broadcast program and participate in the FHSAA network, go to fhsaasports.com/sbp.
Welcome back to the Lakeland Center, the George Jenkins Arena, the 2012 FHSAA Boys Basketball Finals, and our score at the end of the first quarter of this 5A state championship game, Lake Wales leading Terry Parker 21-8. Marty Palman along with the head coach, the girls basketball team at Northeast High School, St. Pete, Will White. And coach, well, Lake Wales dominated. At one point it was 16-1, and then Parker played a little bit even at the end of the first period, but we'll see if that early run for Lake Wales, it may be enough to set them off to a big win.
Yeah, and if you coach Wells for Terry Parker, that's exactly what you're telling your team. You know, you kind of always do the opposite. So things are going bad, you got to tell them about the good things. Things are going too well, you got to tell them about things you got to do better. So right there, he's like, hey, you know, you're down 13, but we were down 15. You kind of took their shot. We've been even against them, so you can hang with these guys. Let's take a couple points at a time and let's just keep chipping away at that lead. But you can play with these guys, so let's get out there and get them.
We see Coach Elijah Wells there, and six players scoring for Lake Wales. Very balanced scoring in the first quarter. Russell Wilson had five. Marcel White and Antoine Hadley with four. Douglas Brooks and Alante Finner with three. 2 points for Jaquavion Williams as Lake Wales at 2-3 is on the other side. Lamar Seymour with five. Chris Jornet with 2 points. Joshua Parks with one at the free throw line for Terry Parker. As the ball into Seymour. Seymour at the only three of the quarter for the Braves, and Seymour able to lay it in.
Yeah, they're going to have to make a little run here. Wilson's out, and again, there was a drop-off there in defense. Right now you have Shaquille Snell playing point defense, so Lake Wells trying to get a little rest there. They say they play a lot of people because they play so up-tempo, they got to save some legs a little bit.
Finner with reverse layup, no good. Follow, no good by Williams, and quickly across half court goes Keith Williams. Now Williams will drive in. Right-handed floater is short. Trying to get his own rebound is Williams, and it's a jump ball. Possession error will give it back. to Lake Wales. Lake Wales shooting 49%. They cooled off after they hit four of their first six in the first nine. They only hit two of their last 10, so 42%. Pretty good shooting quarter, though. Terry Parker at 30%. Parker with seven turnovers, the three assists, only two turnovers for Lake Wales. They had five assists and also six steals for the Highlanders, who out-rebounded Parker 16-5, eight offensive rebounds to one. So Lake Wales really been hitting the glass hard. Here's Spinner over to the left corner. Now inside to Williams. Williams knocked away by Jeanette, and then Jeanette stepped out of bounds.
Yeah, Seymour is starting to light it up here a little bit with 7 points.
And Mike Rideout pointed out to me that in the semifinal, whatever Nature Coast, Seymour led the way with 23 at 16 in the fourth quarter. As that was a two-point game early in the fourth, and Terry Parker beat Nature Coast by 26. Driving the baseline, reverse layup good for Alante Fenner.
And that is their M.O. They can get on a big run there. So, again, they're hanging around. You don't want to be down 13, but they've been there, and they've had some big runs. So let's see if they have a couple of them in there to kind of make it a game.
Ricardo Harris dribbling around. Now we'll drive up and under, finger roll short, and the loose ball ends up with Lake Wales. Here's Russell Wilson now back in for the Highlanders. Being guarded by Harris. For a screen, now backs off. Williams now does go around a ball screen. Now out to a three for Snell. Right corner's good as he falls down. Shaquille Snell with a couple threes in the semifinal win. And he hits one here, and now it's back to a 16-point lead.
Yeah, that almost was an NBA kind of style offense there. You got a high screen and roll, and you put your shooter down the corner, and you just attack that screen and roll and pitch to the three-pointer. Good.
Jeanette hits a three. Second three of the game for Terry Parker. Jeanette with five, and now it's again a 13-point edge for Lake Wales. Under 6 minutes to go, second quarter.
And obviously you want to score, but it's double as good because then that keeps Lake Wales from pushing transition. So when you get a score there, that kind of slows them down a little bit, and they're not quite as good, obviously, in the half court as they are in transition.
Finner drives in. Shot was too strong. Keith Williams out of the way. It's turned over. Then thrown back in the backcourt and thrown right to Ricardo Harris.
Yeah, that's smart, though. You never save it right underneath the other team's basket, yeah. So you kind of launch it towards your own basket.
There's another three for Keith Williams, his first basket of the game, and a timeout taken by Billy Washington. We have a 10-point game. So Parker, again, making a run here after being down 15 earlier, hanging around within 10. First timeout used by Lake Wales. They have four remaining.
Yeah, Lake Wales here, you know, they're predicated on defense becoming their offense. So what's happening now, Terry Parker's on their little run, so they're having to set up into half-court offense, and they're just not quite as good at that as what they do well running it. So, you know, they're going to try to have to pick up their tempo on defense a little bit better.
Coach Rick Victor was here on Thursday night doing the game, the Terry Parker game. He asked me, who is Terry Parker? Well, I am from Jacksonville. I looked it up, and somebody told me I was actually at a game at Terry Parker in football season. He was a local philanthropist in the Arlington area there in Jacksonville who donated money for the land where the school sits. So they named it after him. So that's who Terry Parker is, a local Jacksonville philanthropist there. That was in the 50s. The school has been around since the 50s.
Well, I was going to ask that.
And I actually remembered I just asked that story last fall when I was at Terry Parker. So, all right, we're back to action with Lake Wales as White had it taken away. Ball saved out of bounds and then saved by Snell, and it's saved to Jeanette. So Terry Parker will head the other way. Here's Keith Williams. He'll try a long three. It's short this time. Rebound fought for underneath. Wilson has it.
Yeah, both teams' intensity's kind of evened out here now a little bit.
4:50 to go, second quarter in our 5A state championship game. Wilson will pull up. Free throw line jumper is no good. Back of the rim. Loose ball on the fourth fought for, and Parker comes out with it. Poole had it and lost it. And now Jeanette comes up with a loose ball. Solomon Poole now back in for Terry Parker. Morris Tisby also in for the Braves.
Which is interesting because they made the run without him, but you know, maybe give him that second shot to kind of get, he got some of the rust off a little bit, see if he can help you out a little bit more here.
This is Tisby left wing. Slipping down is Cedric Christian. Shot inside, no good by Tisby. Loose ball tapped out, and now Snell ahead to Finner, who lays it in. Boy, I tell you, Lake Wales likes to tip that ball out and get a run going, and their guards are so quick. Finner again has seven off the pass in from Shaquille Snell, and Lake Wales by 12.
Yeah, Terry Parker's got to be really conscious. A lot of times you have one safety. They might have to consider going to two safeties, where only three people rebound and two people are conscious on getting back on defense.
Williams with a floater misses from 10 feet. He then knocks the ball out of bounds, and it will be Lake Wales ball after our media timeout. 3:59 left here in the second quarter. Lake Wales by 12. Coming up this afternoon, This is the media timeout as both teams have four timeouts remaining. Coming up this afternoon, we'll have the 6A state championship game beginning at 1:35. Mike Rideout will have the call on with Coach Will White. That should be a good one. Miami-Norland against Leesburg. Leesburg looking to repeat as state champs. They won in 4A last year. Won a thriller over Jacksonville Wolfson by a point yesterday. Norland knocked off Winter Haven. So looking forward to that game this afternoon. I think, to me, maybe the best game of the day, the 8A game tonight, should be as well.
Yeah, that should be very, very even. Watching the end of that Leesburg game yesterday, back and forth, that last 2 minutes was fun. In fact, I watched it two or three times going back on the archive here. And so Leesburg being able to pull that out there, and it's kind of throwing me off a little bit because Lake Wales has those same colors as Leesburg, pretty close.
You're right. Leesburg, we'll see them coming up again at 1:35. Later today at 5:05, the 7A state championship game. Been called the Ely Invitational there, but Ely needs to have to win still. To win the state title, they'll play Orlando Oak Ridge, making their first appearance in a state championship game. That's coming up at 5:05, and then tonight at 8:35 p.m., our final championship of the 2012 FHSAA Boys Basketball Finals in Class 8A. Hialeah Gardens will take on Oviedo Haggerty. Haggerty with a big win over Vero Beach last night in the 8A semis.
Excellent crowd here today, both sides. You can kind of see on your screen the other side, but behind us is just as thick.
Yeah, really a good crowd for 10:05 a.m. We've seen that most of the week. Yesterday, a good crowd from Leesburg in the early game, and a foul on Poole, much to Coach Wells' chagrin.
Yeah, he's basically saying, look, Gabe, if we're going to get called for that, then you better get that on the other end, too.
Actually, they called that on Tisby, so that's his first. 16 foul on Parker. Parker now shooting 32%, and Lake Wells at 42%. Both teams have hit 3 3-pointers. And again, the rebounds are all in favor of Lake Wales. 22-9, 9-2 offensively. 6 steals for Lake Wales, only 3 turnovers. They had 7 assists. And Parker picking it up now. 7 turnovers, 6 assists for them.
Yeah, and most of that is not, usually if you see turnovers like that, there's some sort of press going on. But that's just good half-court defense causing those turnovers.
Finner with a drive-in, misses a shot. Tip no good by Christian. Final tip up and in. By Marcel White.
Get a triple-double on the same possession. And 10 rebounds.
White now with 6. It's 30-16. And then it's turned over by Poole. And now ahead to Finner. Finner around Jernet. Oh, he's tripped up. Finner's going to shoot 2. As Jernet will pick up his first foul. And again, Poole a little rusty and the ball taken away. I'm taking the words out of your mouth.
I'm telling you.
To let you do the coaching.
No, it's good. It's good because I think we're all thinking the same thing because they do seem to be running a lot more smoothly when he's not in there. And that's not trying to hate on the guy or anything
that. It's just the
rusty.
6 weeks off is big.
And, so that's great minds think alike.
I'm glad you said that. Free throw, though, missed by Finner, as Finner today is 0 for 3 at the line.
I'm going to start throwing stuff at you.
Michael Hoy checks out for Terry Parker. And we'll see Michael Hoy, Kevin Payne checking in for Hoy, as the free throw good for Finner, who has 8 points. And it's, again, a 15-point lead. It was 10 a couple minutes ago, so Lake Wales starting to turn it up again. Poole across half court. Now Wilson on him again. Into Seymour. Seymour free throw line jumper almost off the glass. In and out, no good. Rebounded by Wilson as Seymour almost banked that one in.
I can't tell you how impressed I am with Wilson. He's playing full court one-on-one man defense. And most people, a good dribbler, can get by somebody because they have the whole court to work with. You know, but he's able to kind of drop a good angle, so pressure the ball without getting beat. And that's a really special thing, and he's getting rebounds. So I think he really is what makes Lake Wales tick.
Well, Wilson now taking a while. Now he'll drive around Payne, and then Wilson tripped up.
Something.
No foul. Free throw line extended jumper good for Finner. Boy, he went down hard. There was no call. So 10 for Finner, but still it's a 17-point lead. They've doubled up Parker again.
Yeah, that's one, you know, blocker charge that, you know, that's such a, you know, crash that almost something needs to be called there. Otherwise, you can really kind of get out of control. The kids start thinking, especially high school level kids start thinking, you know, I can be real aggressive and play hard and just want to be careful.
Air ball on a long 2 by Payne. Wilson now throws it up to Finner. Finner between 2 defenders now to White. White will try a 3 top of the key. It's short. And loose ball rebound ends up with Patrick Baker. Now with a Payne, now Kevin Payne in the game, another senior for this Parker team.
Yeah, Lake Wales defense, again, it's just so solid right there. He was looking for a head fake, Terry Parker, to drive there.
Poole with a long 3, it's no good. In and out, rebound fought for. Boy, Christian throwing moving those elbows around, and he gets a timeout. Instead for Lake Wales, they now have three remaining, and they've gone on a 7-0 run to extend the lead to 17 with 1:25 to go in the second quarter.
Yeah, see, speaking of those elbows, three things can happen with elbows. You can if you throw your elbows around, there's no contact, that you can actually call a violation on that, like a travel. You don't see that very often. And
that's a travel when you move the elbows and not the feet?
No, they can call it. It's like a travelation.
Oh, okay.
There's three things. So they can call it a violation. They can call it just a normal foul. And if you make contact, it's a technical foul.
A technical foul with the elbow, yeah.
Yeah, if you're throwing your body.
Even if you're moving the elbow, you can actually get called. Okay,
right.
That's interesting. I didn't know the violation part of that.
Yeah, you don't see that very often. And I think, that's a good call. If no one's around but you're just really going crazy, they can call that a violation for the safety of the game.
This will be Lakewell's ball again. They already lead it by 17, and they've led from the beginning of this game. It was 16-1 early, and then Parker cut it to 10, and now Lakewell's back up 17. We have a minute 17 to go before halftime. Here's Wilson quickly across half court. Now out comes Kevin Payne to guard Russell Wilson. Over to White. White in at the free throw line, driving in is Williams, and he's able to get it to go.
They're just so strong. They just try to fight through every screen, every body, play tough defense.
35-16 pull around Wilson. Wilson will get the foul call at half court. Wilson just really didn't move off pool quickly enough, and he picks up his first foul. That's the 16th foul on Lake Wales. Parker with seven, and with 50.6 seconds left, still one more foul for Lake Wales to give before Parker will be in a one-on-one. So we'll have an inbounds pass for Keith Williams as Jeanette checks out. And here's the inbounds pass to Poole. Poole across half court around Snell. Poole driving all the way in. Wild shot, no good, out of control. And the loose ball rebound ends up with Snell.
Well, Lake Wales senior laden, but they have five sophomores on the bench, so they're kind of getting that next group ready for their next run.
There's a two from the baseline. Good for Marcel White. Well, he can hit from everywhere. He has eight, and it's 37-16. So a 21-point lead for Lake Wales. See if Parker holds for the final shot. Here's Harris. No, instead missing the shot is Parks. No rebounds from Parker. They are one and done. Both timed out. Lake Wales moves it across half court. Brooks now with 11, with 10. Out to White. He's going to try a three top of the key. Why not? It's short. Loose ball to Finner. Finner drives in. Shot rejected by Seymour. Brooks knocked down. Had it. He's traveled. Nope, a jump ball. And the possession arrow will give it to Terry Parker. 2.6 seconds to go, and the Braves will have a chance for the final shot.
Yeah, that's a right call. He kind of had his hand on top of the ball just briefly enough to call the jump ball.
And Harris had that shot blocked, actually, by Brooks. And that's the end of a very successful first quarter for the Lake Wales Highlanders. Looking for their second state boys basketball title in the history of their school. They are rolling right now over Terry Parker. It's 37-16 at halftime over a 5A state championship game. Marty Palmer along with the coach Will White. We will return in about 9 minutes with the first half stats. Also, look ahead to our schedule the rest of the day. You're watching the 2012 FHSAA boys basketball finals on the FHSAA network.
We can get a player up here.
Oh, that's good stuff.
A Wiley Ballard graphic.
Do you want me to start the stream?
Start the stream. Camera three. Beautiful. We're coming in on one.
For more information on how your school can join the Play On School broadcast program and participate in the FHSAA network, go to fhsaasports.com/sbp.
Welcome back to the Lakeland Center, the 2012 FHSAA Boys Basketball Finals. Our score in our 5A championship game at the half, the Lake Wales Highlanders leading the Terry Parker Braves out of Jacksonville 37-16. Marty Palman along with Coach Will White as we get ready for the second half of our first of four state championship games today here in Lakeland. And to look at the first half stats, field goals for Terry Parker, they shot 6 for 24, only 25%, 3 of 8 from three-point range, 1 for 5 at the line, 6 assists and 8 turnovers. 2 offensive rebounds, 9 defensive rebounds for the Terry Parker Braves. And for Lake Wales, much better stats for the Highlanders. 15 of 36 from the floor, 42%. 3 of 10 from three-point range, 4 for 10 at the line. Not a great performance there, but they haven't really needed it. 9 assists, only 4 turnovers. Doing a great job there. Also 7 steals for Lake Wales. 13 offensive rebounds, 18 defensive rebounds. They have a 20-rebound advantage, 11 on the offensive glass. And, well, they have a 21-point lead, and that along with the steals and the turnovers kind of sums up the first half.
Yeah, when you see stats like that, the 31 rebounds to 11, that just says it all right there. To get 31 rebounds and a half, when you're actually shooting pretty well, sometimes you can get a lot of rebounds because you can't make a shot. But that's not the case here. That's just effort and determination and just really well coached. They kind of really have a good flow. You can kind of see that they've played a lot together, that they just kind of know where they're going to be at. They have one single game plan. Let's play hard. Let's get some lockdown defense. Trust each other. Make it happen. They're fun to watch.
7 players scored for Lake Wales in the first half, led by Alante Finner with 10 points. And they also had a really balanced half. Marcel White with 8. 5 for Russell Wilson. 4 points for Antoine Halley and Jaquavion Williams. 3 points for Shaquille Snell and Douglas Brooks as Lake Wales hit 3 threes in the first half. For Terry Parker, Lamar Seymour with 7. Chris Turnett with 5. 3 points for Keith Williams. 1 point for Joshua Parks. We're underway as we start the second half with Lake Wales in the ball.
If you're Coach Wells here, you just want to have a tell him we want to win this. Let's win this quarter, right? We're down 21. Let's even if it's 1 point, 2 points, 3 points, but let's win this quarter. Give ourselves a chance going into the fourth quarter.
Well, that's a good start for Parker as Finner throws it away. Now Ricardo Harris across half court again. Russell Wilson right on him. Wilson in the first half, and there's another steal. There's Brooks with his another steal. He'll drive and miss a shot. Tunk, followed by Hadley. Goes way out to half court as he missed it. And Lake Wales will turn it over off the missed dunk for Brooks. That's his third steal of the game. Russell Wilson has 3 as well. But Hadley missing the dunk. He had 2 fouls in the first half. Actually sat out most of the second quarter. Driving in and out of control was Williams. The follow, though, up and in by Ricardo Harris. First basket of the game for the senior guard, Ricardo Harris, and Parker trails it by 19.
Yeah, that's actually a good move. I'm not sure if that was intentional. I'll have a Coach Wells. One thing I would consider is moving your point guard off of there because Wilson, I think, just got off the ball foul there, pushing through.
Well, they're going to say offensive foul. Yeah, as you mentioned on Wilson. And actually Brooks gets his first foul.
But what I was saying here is Wilson was playing point defense, so now they've moved off there, and now they're having Keith Williams as the point guard, so now you have Finner playing defense because Wilson was just not allowing Terry Parker to get into any sort of offense.
Williams to Seymour. Seymour inside to Joshua Parks, who had it knocked away, and here we go on the run. Lake Wales ahead to Brooks. Brooks misses the layup. He's fouled. And Brooks will shoot 2. Nice pass in from Finner from near half court, and Finner's another guy who they just seem to come at you with all kinds of guards.
Brooks did a good job right there. When he was going in there, he went in strong. He didn't run away from the contact. He kind of ran into it and kept good body control so that he could get to the free throw line, not giving the defender a chance to cut in front of him and block it.
Seymour picks up the foul, his first. The first free throw good. For Douglas Brooks, who has 4 points, he'll get a second. It's a 20-point lead. Both teams with 1 personal foul, a team foul in the second half.
Interesting kind of the way he throws that ball to himself on his free throw. I love watching people's free throws because they're just everyone's got their own unique little style. You kind of the result, you always kind of end the same, but just watching them shoot their different ways.
3 right corner, no good by Harris. Rebound on the floor, out of bounds, will be back to Lake Wales. So Lake Wales, finalists a year ago. Boy, ran into a nationally ranked team in Dwyer. We have some players on that team, including Jacoby Brissett, now playing quarterback at the University of Florida, who thought about playing basketball for a while for Billy Donovan. But Lake Wales this year, they knew they were loaded, all the seniors, and this year they've been nationally ranked themselves. And like you said, we'll see Ely later today in 7A. Lake Wales and Ely would be a fun game to watch. Pass underneath, layup missed. by White, where we'll have a blocking foul coming up against Parker.
And give it to Lake Wales that, you know, when you have a good team like that to play a tough schedule. They played some really tough teams. They played a Tampa Prep, a Final Four team, Winter Haven. We'll probably go over that list as well. You know, they really had a good schedule.
Bishop Perot is usually pretty good, beat by 25. They roll over St. Petersburg. They were a semifinalist by 18, and first free throw is good for Marcel White. He has 9. And yeah, they took on a university school who was also lost in the regional semifinal round, but they were also one of the top teams in the state. Second free throw is good as well. They played, lost to a team from New Jersey and a team from California. The only two losses in Florida were University and Montverde. They lost to Montverde by 3 the second to last game of the season. Then they beat Tampa Prep in their final game.
And Tampa Prep won a state championship. So,
and how about this? They beat Leesburg playing for the 6A title tonight by 45.
Wow.
that's a state champ from a year ago.
That just shows you the gap on just how talented these teams are.
Well, that ball out of bounds will stay with Parker. It's a 23-point lead for Lake Wales. And we mentioned they made it all the way back. This was the goal. And they're on their way right now, it would seem. There's an air ball from the corner by Williams on a 3, and Marcel White on the run out. Lake Wales has numbers. Finner alley-oop to Marcel White.
That was a 4-on-1. Terry Parker not even getting back at all on defense there, so that's just going to be too easy.
I think Parker is feeling a little bit like they're a little bit outmatched here as Jurnett had it knocked away. Then the hands of Tisby. Tisby will go cross-court to Seymour. Seymour almost stolen away again. Now Seymour in trouble, and Lake Wales really swarming the ball. Here's Solomon Poole. He'll try a 3. It's good. So Poole gets on the – that's a 2. I'm sorry. That's a 2.
Yeah, I thought it was a 3-2. They call it a 2.
It gets his first basket of the game here in the third quarter. Poole back in a minute ago, and it's 43-20. Wilson drives around Poole. He's fouled. A foul on the floor. Well, some move there by Russell Wilson as Poole picks up his second foul.
Yeah, we keep coming back to him a little bit. 13 points a game or whatever. But just his complete game. Just complete game. Defense, offense.
So Lake Wales to inbound. It's going to be Alante Finner. Finner throws it into Brooks. Brooks, Douglas Brooks will retrieve. Now top of the key, Hadley at the free throw line. White now back to Brooks. Now to Wilson. It's hard for me to tell Brooks and Wilson apart. They almost look the same out there. Same size, same looking body. Here's Wilson. And, ooh, he is hit hard. And Poole's going to pick up the foul. And Solomon Poole needs to be careful at this point. That was a little bit of a frustration foul, I think. He picks up his third. I know they called it, I'm sorry, on Tisby. It looked like Poole was there. And my apologies. Poole has 2, Tisby with 2. And 14 fouls now on the Braves. Inbounds pass goes to Wilson. Now Wilson being double-teamed, ball on the floor, and it's taken away by Tisby. Jump ball in the possession arrow. We'll give it back to Parker, or do we have a foul? Nope, timeout. Parker got the ball and called timeout. So with 4:47 to go, third quarter, Billy Washington wants to know how it's a timeout. If Parker didn't even really have it, they were trying to get a jump ball, so the Braves use a timeout. They have now 3 remaining. Or did they say Lake Wales had a timeout?
That's what I'm confused about is because I'm not sure what Coach Washington would be complaining about because I thought what happened is Lake Wales had called the timeout and they were going to give him the ball, give them the ball back. So,
well, that might be the announcer here called it as late as timeout Terry Parker, but apparently Lake Wales, according to the scoreboard, used the timeout. So Lake Wales with 2 remaining. Parker still has 4 timeouts to go. With 4:47 to go in the third quarter, it's 43-20. So Lake Wales up 21 at the half, continuing to just build a little bit by little on this lead, and they have led early 16-1 run, and they have just rolled since.
And you said about that the running clock that they had on Leesburg. On their way here, there was a really good Tampa Jesuit team that was just really phenomenal. I got to see play this year. Well, they even running clocked them in the semifinals. So when you start seeing those sort of things, when you're running clocking teams that are really, really good teams. You're just at a whole another level. And again, that's not disrespectful to those teams. Those are solid teams. Terry Parker, solid team right now. They're just running up against a little bit better of a team here in Lake Wales.
They're putting a graphic on the board here. Sorry, I was looking at that on the scoreboard by Bright House Network. Since Terry Parker's last state championship, 1967, what times have changed. Gas was 53 cents a gallon. A new house was $14,250. That was 45 years ago. Last time Terry Parker won a state basketball title, and the foul is on Williams, his second, and it looks like it might be a little bit longer as they are having a tough one today with this Lake Wales team.
Yeah, that actually, that Gibbs team was coached by longtime and Pinellas superstar Freddie Dials, who in Pinellas County, if you're around Pinellas County, there's like the coaching tree, the Freddie Dials coaching tree, and actually even played into the St. Pete game. The Freddie Dials was Dan Wright's coach, who was Lakewood's longtime coach, who won a few state championships here, and his assistant coach, Chris Blackwell, is the coach at St. Pete High. Hmm. So everything's kind of run through Freddie Dials in Pinellas County boys basketball.
Five inside, and an easy layup again for Marcel White, who now has 14. He's the leading scorer for Lake Wales. They lead by 25. How about the Cone coaching tree continues? Reggie Cone won his fourth state title in 5 years Wednesday for Orlando Christian Prep in 2A. His brother Josh will go for his first state title tonight at Hagerty in Oviedo, the 8A championship game against Hialeah Gardens. I'm pretty sure I had to look this up, but I believe brothers have never won a state title for two different teams in the same finals. So safe to believe that's never happened.
That's a nice coaching tree. And I remember watching Reggie Cone play at USF. He was a really good player. And a lot of locals on that team as well. You had B.B. Walden from Lakeland Kathleen right down the street over here. You had Altron Jackson, which was from Sarasota Booker. And Seth Greenberg was in charge there. And I used to love watching USF play their nice 1-3-1. You don't see that a lot in college, but they were really successful with that. And so that was a fun little team.
Jeanette picks up his second foul, 16th foul. Douglas Brooks will be at the line. He has 5 points. He's 2-for-2 at the line today. It's 45-20 lead with 3:29 to go. And actually, Seth Greenberg was here yesterday, sitting almost right next to us here as Brooks was able to get the free throw to go. Now at Virginia Tech, formerly at USF, having a rough year this year, a lot of suspensions. But he was here yesterday looking at some players and was here on Media Row.
Yeah, he's seen since he left USF. He's had some good teams, but seems to be just can't quite get over the hump.
Say the NCAA just doesn't seem to like Virginia Tech. They get left out.
On the bubble every year.
So the second free throw good for Brooks. He has 7, and it's 47-20. Lake Wales is cruising here in the 5A state championship game. A reminder, coming up this afternoon at 1:35, we'll have the 7A or 6A state title game. Mike Radout, along with Coach Will White, will bring you Leesburg and Miami Norland. Miami Norland looking for their third state title in 7 years, and Leesburg looking to repeat as state champs. That should be a good one coming up. And then this afternoon at 5:05, Pompano Beach Ely, considered the huge favorite, will take on Orlando Oak Ridge. And myself, Marty Palmer, will have the call with Terry Prim, the head men's basketball coach at Palm Beach Atlantic University, will join me for that one. Then tonight we'll wrap it all up with our 8A championship game at 8:35. Again, that'll be Mike Rideout with Coach Terry Prim. Hialeah Gardens and Oviedo Hagerty, and both those teams looking for the first eight titles in boys basketball. So that'll be a lot of fun. The first 8A championship game, the first 7A championship game coming up later today. The Lake Wales fans on their feet. They are enjoying this one from nearby Polk County, about 15 miles south there of the Lakeland Center. And we've got a good crowd for this 10:05 a.m. game.
That Leesburg game yesterday in the semifinals was a really good game against Wolfson. Yep. Came down to, I watched that last couple minutes just over and over again, and so to see them pull it out, I think their experience came in there a little bit as well.
Well, Wolfson had a three-point lead with a minute to go, and Leesburg scored 4 points in about 11 seconds. They had a steal and another layup as the reverse layup, no good, inside. And loose ball on the floor. Poole takes it away, and we'll have a foul underneath on Lake Wales as Joshua Parks missed a shot. But, yeah, Leesburg had Leesburg scored off a layup on a steal. Wolfson had the ball for the final minute and ran it down about 5 seconds and turned it over, and then that was it. Leesburg holds on to win by one as probably one of the best games of the tournament. There's a turnover. Oh, look out. I thought Coach White's going to save John, our cameraman. I thought Solomon Poole was going to take out another cameraman here. He already took out the Bright House cameraman of the basket.
I was like, hey, I'm going to help him out here because he's defenseless over there. He's got nothing. Got the camera.
He's got the camera and the chair.
Sticking up for our teammate here.
Coach White was diving for that one, too.
All right, I'll be honest. I was really going for under the table. Let's protect myself.
Oh, and almost taken away out of bounds. Off of Fenner. And all I could see was number two, and then the White heading for another camera.
Get out the way.
Solomon Poole just wants to be on camera, I think. All inbounds to Harris.
Those close game losses, win or losses, you just kind of go over every possession so many times. We had a game earlier this week with Tampa Prep in the semifinals against Providence that we were talking about, and it just back and forth. And Providence missed a breakaway layup in the last minute that would have made it a 5-point lead, and they end up losing in overtime. So, you know, you feel bad for that kid because you know that he's thinking about that.
Travel on Parker Wilson with a spin move, and a jump ball is Williams. Quavion Williams is tied up. It'll be back to Terry Parker. So, and that game was good yesterday. Don't forget, boy, Oviedo, Coach Ed Kirshner, back in the Final Four, and tough loss for his team by 1 point. They went back and forth with Oak Ridge. But Ed Kirshner has that shot blocked, but a foul coming up underneath on Lake Wales. Ed Kirshner won almost 800 games as a coach, and it was good to see him in the semis. Tough loss for his team.
Yeah, earlier, speaking of 800 wins, we covered the Dillard girls winning their third straight championship, and Coach Pender with her 804th or something win.
Yeah, she's won over 800. Ed Kirshner's won, I think, 796, so they're very close there. That is just a lot of wins. Harris set the line. Free throw, no good. Back of the rim.
Right now, if you're Lake Wales, you don't take anything for granted. If you're the coach there, you see them still sticking predominantly with the starters, trying to get to a running clock, you know, so you can get that game over with, and then maybe you can start worrying about getting some other people a chance to play. But you don't mess around in state championship games. Regular season, maybe you kind of, you know, work on some things, but here you want to get out with the debut, know nothing, you never know what's going to happen. So they're still kind of pushing tempo and momentum.
Well, it's still a 27-point lead as ball inside is knocked away, and the loose ball put back up and in by Brooks. Brooks now with 9, and it's a 29-point lead, 49-20. Parker just can't find any offense. Poole will try to jump on the baseline. It's short from 18, rebounded by Lake Wales. Wilson now across to Marcel White, and then White had it taken away. It ends up in the hands of Finner.
And when Poole's in there, it seems like Terry Parker's just a little bit more stagnant on offense. They're just kind of standing around watching, waiting for him to do something instead of running any sort of movement.
Brooks now will have a running clock and four more points, as Mike points out, as Harris lost it, and Poole just loses it out of bounds. And you're right, Parker again is gone on a drought with Solomon Poole in the ballgame, and Poole's going to come back out. We may not see him anymore.
And he goes and sits down there at the end of the bench next to an assistant coach.
I don't know what the fans are cheering for, but hope it's not what I think it is.
I was thinking the same thing. I didn't see maybe who was coming in.
You can tell, and Elijah Wells had to do it. He had to put him in. And you can tell it's just a tough game for the kid. It's been a while off. He looks a little defeated on the bench. Shot no good by Williams. White misses the tip. Now it's Finner in the corner, and we'll have a foul on Parker. Seventh team foul, so 1-on-1 for Lake Wales. 1:19 to go, third quarter, and Tisby gets his third foul. And you don't see this a lot in a state championship game, but we are close to a running clock, and that, again, will kind of show you how dominant Lake Wales has been from the start of this game.
Yeah, because you look at Terry Parker, you know, they're a solid team. They played tough competition this year and had a really good team. So, again, what we said earlier, too, I think still holds true. If you get to that point where you're close to a running clock, it's not so much, you know, any indicator about you, but just how good the other teams are.
3 in the corner is no good by Keith Williams, rebounded by Wilson as we have a minute to go third quarter.
Yeah, you've seen it a few times in the semifinals, but like you said, just you don't see pushing a running clock very often in finals.
Well, we're not there yet. It's 31-point lead. It might be about to be there as a foul. Boy, a hard foul by Tisby. That's his fourth. Is driving in, trying to dunk it home, was Marcel White.
What I really like about Lake Wales here is they've shown a lot of composure and stuff in the sense, like right there, you know, the guy, he went in really, really hard, and a good hard foul. Didn't seem like it was that big a deal. Oh, hey, you fouled me. I'm going to go to the line. I'm going to put him in there. So that, just an overall composure of a team, you know, to play that hard, sometimes you get into the situation where maybe you're a little out of control or you get a little frustrated, but they're completely the opposite. To play that hard, meanwhile maintaining composure, and that's really solid.
You mentioned Terry Parker's schedule. They beat Ed White by 5. That was the playoff team. They beat Sandalwood by 33. They were an 8A playoff team early in the season. Then they lost 3 in a row. They won their first, like, 14 games of the season as a free throw no good. Cross-court pass to Seymour. Lost to Gainesville Eastside. Lost to Ridgeview, who was a playoff team. Lost to Bishop Kenny, who was, like, 24-2 this year. Here's a run-out for Snell. Snell misses the shot. He's fouled. They call intentional on that? Wow, I don't know about that. That didn't look like anything out of the ordinary, but they're going to call the foul on.
You know, what's interesting about that is maybe just the last couple times you've seen some pretty hard fouls.
Yeah.
Because technically an intentional foul could also is a hard foul. In high school basketball, if they deem it to be overly hard, they can call intentional just for that alone, even if you make a play on the ball, but if it's just overly aggressive. I don't think that was overly aggressive. However, I think it's just setting a tone that, hey, yeah, the last couple times you've kind of got out of it, we're not going to let anything go wrong here, so we're going to make sure that we keep this game kind of clean and safe.
Keith Williams, his third foul, so Shaquille Snell shooting the technicals. But looking at Parker, they lost to Wolfson, who was a 6A semifinalist by 4, the Gateway Conference tournament in Jacksonville. Defeated Sandalwood again by 1, 39-38, beat them twice. They were in the 8A regional semis, and then beat Wolfson by 21 in the last game of the season. They were actually the second seed in the district. They had to beat Bishop Kenny on the road, beat him with like 2 seconds to go by 1 point, 36-35, and then went to OT at Ponte Vedra, 1-6, on the road at Rutherford, 1-5. So they had a tough road, really some close games, but they were able to kind of get through the gauntlet and get here to Lakeland, as that's the ninth, now 10th team foul on Parker. Jarnett picks up his third. We'll have two free throws again for Marcel White. And White here in the having a big third quarter has 6 points, now 14 in the game. It's a 32-point lead. It's a two-shot free throw, so he makes or misses the first. 31.8 seconds left here, third quarter.
He has another little kind of little soft foul to call on that, so I think it's pretty obvious here, and it's the right thing to just make sure that here's where things can get really chippy and some bad things can happen. So just let both teams know that we're going to keep calling this game, so keep playing hard, but let's not get out of control.
Finner, I thought Finner knocked out of bounds, but actually it was Terry Parker who lost it.
And you do see a lot of bench players already in for Lake Wales, which, again, is the right thing to do. That's how you build. You see some of these teams that are here just again and again and again. So right now for Lake Wales, you know, put in some of your people, your younger kids. You got Diedrich Brinson in there. He's a sophomore. So just trying to get some other people a chance to kind of work on their game a little bit and get that vibe and carry that in the next year, because obviously all those seniors are going to be gone.
Last 12 seconds of the period, Wilson underneath, travel. And there's a foul. Oh, a travel, you're right, sorry.
That's the second
call
time they called that.
Brinson. Brinson called for the travel. So last 10 seconds of the period. And in the corner, a three-pointer is good for Michael Hoy. And it's the first basket of the game for Hoy, and that's the end of the third quarter. Lake Wales is cruising to the 5A state championship as they lead Terry Parker by 30, 53-23 through three quarters of this 5A state championship game. You're watching the 2012 FHSA Boys Basketball Finals on the FHSA Network. Back to Lakeland in just a moment.
We can get a player up here. Oh, that's good stuff.
All right, perfect. Prepare a Wiley Ballard graphic.
Do you want me to start the stream?
Start the stream. Camera 3. Beautiful. Oh, we're coming in on 1.
For more information on how your school can join the Play On School broadcast program and participate in the FHSAA network, go to fhsaasports.com/SBP.
Welcome back to the Lakeland Center. Marty Palmer along with Coach Will White, and girls basketball coach at Northeast High School in St. Petersburg, as we head to the fourth quarter. And Lake Wales heading towards the 5A state championship. They lead Terry Parker 53-23. It was 37-16 in the half, and then the third quarter, 16-7 in favor of Lake Wales. So now a 30-point edge as we go to the fourth quarter.
If you're Terry Parker here, Coach Wells, you want to just say, hey, all right, guys, let's have some pride here and let's avoid a running clock. I mean, you always want to have something to play for, so set that sort of tone there. And then the opposite for Lake Will, say, let's get it there. Let's get to that running clock. Then, it's, you know, we can kind of start working on some things. Because coaches are neurotic. I mean, it just they've seen everything happen. Even, I promise you, you're not sitting here thinking we're state champ. That's, you're going to coach it up and keep it going.
To the very
let's
end.
Get that running clock.
And Lake Wales, by the way, if they win today, will play in the ESPN Rise Challenge. They have been invited. They will go to that. And it looks like Ely, if they win today, also would be the second Florida team. We're not certain on that, but it looks like the two. Lake yep. Wales is going to be there.
I was going to ask about
maybe.
That.
Mike's trying. Mike won't give me a – I thought it was true, but now I don't know. But apparently that's the way it's going to be, is there's a steal by Williams and – the shot no good, loose ball ends up with Brooks. I know it's an invitation-only tournament, but I got to think Lake Wales, probably the second-best team in the state, maybe one of the best. We'll see Ely later today in the 7A state championship game.
Yeah, that's a nice tournament. I remember a few years ago we lost in girls to Dillard in the state championship, and they went to play in that challenge.
So oh, kind of Dillard?
Yeah, the Dillard girls did. So yeah. It'd be good here to kind of see. I'll definitely tune in and watch that. Watch, see how the best of Florida rates against the best of some other states.
Shot is no good, out of bounds. We'll stay with Parker. On the other end, it was Wilson who scored. He has seven. I wonder if they're going to have a foul. Actually, Jeanette, his fourth on the rebound. That's Parker's over the 10-foul limit, so we'll have two free throws coming up the rest of the way for Lake Wales. And at this point, we are 3 points away from the running clock. We're 39 seconds into the fourth quarter. And how long do you think you see? Well, the starters will probably be in there, I'm assuming, until maybe we get to 35.
Yeah, exactly. If it was like a semifinal game or even on the road to Lakeland, they're probably out already because you just don't want to get anybody hurt. But now it's the last game of the year. Not that it's okay to get hurt, but it's not going to be detrimental to your team in a sense. So give your seniors that have kind of put you back on the map and done a good job, give them a chance to play probably until 35 points. And then at that point, I would see getting some other people a chance to play.
Well, Brooks short on the first free throw. We mentioned Elijah Wells, the coach at Terry Parker, 16 years and his record is right around 500. I mean, he's had some really tough years at Parker, but he's really developed himself a program here. There's a steal and an underhanded layup by Snell off the missed free throw.
Yeah, and that shows a lot of dedication that he must do a really good job, like with his players and discipline and grades and stuff, to be there that long. And I'm glad that the administration stuck with him because he's obviously been able to kind of keep it together and get it here and had a nice little three-year run here on some really good teams.
Foul that time on Snell, his first. He scored on the other end. It's 57-23, so one more point, and he'll have a running clock the rest of the fourth quarter as Harris drives in. Offensive foul, Ricardo Harris. And again, Russell Wilson takes the charge, still playing defense, even up 34.
Yeah, I'm really impressed with this guy. Running the team in the pregame bio, they had talked about that with Coach Washington saying that Wilson's the guy that makes his team click.
Well, we have a timeout called by Terry Parker. They have three remaining. Two for Lake Wales at this point, 7:05 to go. And it's all over but the celebrating for Lake Wales. And Billy Washington has his team set up to win this season, and they have done all that they can do to get there. And, you know, you look at this game today, it's just another symbol of how dominant they've been. They mentioned in the playoffs, their closest game was 31 points in the semifinals. They have just won. And even the district tournament, they won by 33 and 37. Right now they're up 34, and we still have 7 minutes to go.
Yeah, and you go throughout and you look at their season, they did have quite a few, you know, some blowouts. And watching them here today, it's very easy to see why. They just have a complete package of talent and attitude in a positive sense, just working together. Right now you see, look, they're up 34, but Wilson's out there still telling his team, you know, let's keep this together, talking, that leadership, that's just vital for any successful team. Look at them, they're still just kind of talking, playing.
They're communicating, yeah, still up 34. And by the way, looking at the third quarter stat sheet, 38% shooting, 39, not great. But they held Parker to 25% shooting. The rebounds were amazing. 46 rebounds for Lake Wales, 17 for Parker, 20 offensive rebounds. They've also had 8 steals. They forced 13 turnovers and only 8 turnovers themselves and 12 assists. Again, a positive assist-to-turnover ratio, that many rebounds, you're going to win almost all your games. As spinner had it knocked away on the baseline. Harris gets it ahead and driving. Oh, that's, wow, knocked in by Hadley. Actually, probably was, thought it was going to be goaltending. But
yeah, but it still went in. So, but I don't think they were going to call it, but it looked like it had hit the backboard first.
Hoy with five. Michael Hoy scores. He has 5 points. And he didn't get to the 35-point level. It still could happen. With that three, it would. Brooks misses it out the side of the rim and rebounded by Hoy.
I was impressed by Hoy. He took that ball up strong there right there, a lot of confidence. They have him listed as 5'9", so I mean, it probably means he's about 5'6".
And then turned over. Here goes Wilson. Lake Wales with a three on none. Brooks will dunk it home. Douglas Brooks with a huge dunk. He has 13, and it's 59-25.
I did that once, but it was on an 8-foot rim.
Yeah, me too. Driving in, shot blocked again by White, but a foul coming up as right down the middle of the paint was Joshua Parks.
Yeah, real quick, you know, Parker will kind of, you know, you don't want to get beat this bad. It's a rough showing, but, you know, tomorrow, the next day, they're going to realize how special it was to get to a state championship game. They can't take that away from you. That's going to be there forever. You know, that's a special journey that's going to, you're always going to remember.
Free throw is good for Parks. He has 2 points. Both of the line, 2 of 3, and it's 59-26. Solomon Poole will check back out. Actually, I didn't realize he was back in the game. About that.
Like you said, you kind of said a lot, but Lake Wells pushing 50 rebounds.
And there's another one. That's the free throw, no good. Hadley with a rebound. And it's a 33-point lead, and the starter still in the game here is Wilson across half court. Boy, spin move, floater, short. Loose ball rebound one by Keith Williams.
Yeah, at some point you want to start working on getting those other people a chance that are going to be there next year so they can have that vibe, because hopefully your plan is to be here year and again, so that they've been on the court and they've had that experience so that they wouldn't have the nerves, because a coach could come here. We saw Coach Finland from Tampa Prep, what, 8 times? So like he had said, hey, I've been here 8 times, but that doesn't mean all the players have. So, you know, get those people a chance to kind of get on the court and get acclimated, so if you do come back next year, it's not a new experience for them.
And that time thrown away by Harris. Looking at some of the other totals as Finner, not a White. Finner will pull it out near half court. It's like Wales just kind of using some time on the clock.
Yeah, just doing that. You see this as a common stall where you have someone at the free throw line and you just drive and replace with a little three-man game.
Marcel White drives, has it knocked away. It'll stay with Lake Wales. And 11 rebounds for Marcel White. He has 6 offensive boards. 7 rebounds for Alante Finner. 7 for Douglas Brooks. 5 for Jaquavion Williams. 5 for Russell Wilson. And we're talking about guards getting in there and getting 3 rebounds too. So everybody on this team can rebound. This cross-court pass driving all the way in. Floater good for Finner. And now welcome to the running clock.
Yeah, like you said, that's really uncommon for a state championship game.
Three-pointer is short by Michael Hoy, and it won't be long now. There's Lake Wales on the run-out. Welch with a pass to Wilson. Wilson under the... Ooh, well, that's an intentional foul, isn't it?
No. He kind of grabbed him from the shoulder from behind. I'd almost think so.
Williams gets his 4th foul. Surprised they didn't call it there. As we, again, Parker over the 10-foul limit. Or didn't call it that time. Wow. Wilson will shoot 2.
Yeah, they showed the replay there, and it was definitely 2-hand pull from behind. But again, that's what I've liked about Wilson here, especially, but Lake Wells, is just their composure. Again, didn't take it personal, you know, not up, getting all, you know, upset about it. Hey, I'm going to go to the line, let's make free throws, and let's go. And you always have to persevere, so you just kind of see them with that attitude that, you know, we're just going to play hard, and let's just let it happen.
Wilson hits the 2nd free throw. He has 9, and it's a 63-26 lead. Harris across half court. Now into the corner. 3 right corner is an air ball by Michael Hoy. Ooh, down hard. You heard the thud. Goes Jalen Cross, the senior for Terry Parker, down on the floor. That'll be our media timeout with 3:38 to go. They'll help him up. Looks like he's okay, but Wilson picks up his 2nd. Probably hate to hear that sound any time on the floor. And now he's falling down. I think his lower, his back, or maybe hurting him as Cross goes back down. Right hip, maybe.
Yeah, I'm surprised you don't see that more. If you see there, Wilson was just boxing him out. But, you know, you elevate so high and that if you're boxing out and you have any momentum, you kind of undercut somebody. purely unintentional, but still, you know, when someone gets in the air and you try to box somebody out that's in the air, you kind of get that accidental undercut.
3:34 to go. Cross walking it off. Looks like he's flipping a little bit okay now. He'll head to the bench, and we'll have our final media timeout of this 5A state championship game as we head to the end. And for Lake Wales, boy, you can't find a much more dominant performance than they've had in this 5A playoffs. Boy, they have just been dominant. They've beaten everyone by at least 30 points.
Yeah, it's going to be fun if they do make the ESPN Challenge there to kind of see them go on after that and come up against some other the other team's best. And Eli would be the other team that you just seen just kind of those two teams really at a whole other level.
Well, we've had three games now with a running clock this week. And two of them were Lake Wales, the semifinals and finals. Actually, four. Lander Christian Prep, the semifinals.
That's right.
And then the other was Ely in the semifinals yesterday against St. Petersburg. And St. Pete, you know, they made it. They've been in a while. Fortunately, they draw Ely. It's kind of, you look at them and go, well, thanks for coming, but, man, sorry, you're going to have to play the best team in the state, maybe.
Yeah, our first one here, we came here with the girls again, and we ran across Winter Haven girls and Tiffany Hayes, All-American, who went 2 years at UConn without losing a game.
Yep.
So that was kind of tough. And so you're like, hey, you know, but sometimes you just say, you know, just knowing they're going to states. That's what everybody – very few teams you hear all year talking about, we're going to go into the state championship. Let's get the states. At that point, anything can happen. So they can never take that away from you. The Final Four is just a special, special thing. So Terry Parker, they'll get over this pretty fast and realize that, you know, they worked hard. They got there. They represented their region. Had a great semifinal win. And just couldn't get past, you know, just a much better team.
Patrick Baker at the line hits the first free throw, and the second rolls in. Terry Parker is going to lose Harris, Williams, Jernette, Parks, all starters. Kevin Payne and is also a senior. Also Jalen Cross, some other bench players. Solomon Poole will be back. We'll see what the future means for him as Lake Wales now will get some of their younger players into the game. They're going to check out the starters as Wilson driving in, and he's fouled. Foul is on Michael Hoy, his first. Two free throws for Wilson, and then you'll see the five senior starters for this Lake Wales team are going to check out. And also, and Billy Washington's going to have to rebuild a bit. You mentioned, though, they're going to bring back Brooks, Snell, their juniors, as well as some of the other players. But Welch, a starter, Fenner, a starter, Wilson, White, Hadley, those are all seniors. Cedric Christian, DeQuavion Williams, so a lot of seniors leaving this team. As Wilson hits the first free throw, and there you go. They're celebrating on the Lake Wales side. 10 points for Wilson. He'll check out after this free throw at 64-28. And second free throw is good for Russell Wilson.
Yeah, it's going to be tough next year with all the seniors graduating from Terry Parker and having Poole come back and try to lead that team. It's going to be tough.
65-28, under 2 minutes to go. Roshan Pitts in the game for the Braves. Now to the three in the left corner, no good, and the rebound by Baker. The shot no good by Parks. Poole will try a three right in front of us. It's in and out, no good. And out of bounds. We'll stay with Terry Parker. Interested to see what happens the senior season of Solomon Poole. You know he's going to be a highly sought-after player, but there's a lot of questions about him.
Yeah, you know, at that next level, the college coaches, you know, their jobs are kind of on the line. So when they really invest in a player, you know, they got to know that they're going to be there for them and whatever. So he's kind of hurt himself this year with, you know, two ejections. That stuff kind of carries with you.
Jumper good for Kevin Payne, and Elijah Wells will take a timeout. Parker with two remaining, and that's the thing. 57 seconds to go at 65-30. There's a great lineage there. I mean, Stacy Poole was an all-state performer at Forest High School in Jackson, his father. And Solomon Poole now, what is he doing?
He's arguing with the official about something. Down 35. I can't keep it in anymore. You're down 35, and you've been ejected twice.
Yeah, you got to. And the thing is, you just sat out 6 weeks. And, you know, it's just kind of the body language of the kid. He sits on the end of the bench. He's kind of to himself. And I know we've been trying to be nice about it, but it's tough to be nice when you watch his demeanor.
Yeah,
he came over here and started talking right to us. I don't know what about, but and in fact, he's gone.
Yeah, coach,
he's
going to
leave the bench. And that's the thing. Stacy Poole, a great player at the University of Florida, all-SEC performer. And also, his brother was another great player at Providence. That's where he won a state title 2 years ago. But obviously, he's troubled right now, it seems.
Yeah, I read a nice article. Everybody should look this up at home. It was Jay Billis, and it was called Toughness. And it was really good. It was about all the things that you could do as a player that has nothing to do with talent. And one of the things that always stuck with me was your nonverbal communication. Like how, and that's one thing I was really impressed with Wilson. His nonverbals are good. You know, clapping his hands, picking his teammates up, doing those sort of things builds everybody up.
Yeah.
And Poole's kind of struggles with that. Well, let's kind of go back here to Lake Wells a little bit. Just a pure dominant
performance. Yeah, let's focus on that as Brinson hits the free throw. And this is going to be the end of the game. We have 25 seconds to go. And you're right. Focus on the really a great performance that has been for Lake Wales. And this game was 16-1. It was 10 points at once, 1 point, and then it got to 21 and a half. Really never in doubt as the second free throw is good. There's a steal by David Campbell. Free throw line jumper no good by Campbell. Loose ball on the floor. It will be the end of the game as Campbell is going to have it knocked away, and that's the ball game. And Lake Wales can celebrate the state championship. Their big crowd that came here for about 15 miles away. What was that, a
backflip?
Backflip by Shaquille Snell. He'll be back. He's a junior. And then we have a couple guys on the floor. Lake Wales is two in the floor jump. And they are enjoying this one. They made it all the way last year, the state championship game, lost in the final. And Billy Wash and his team comes back. And this year they are able to get it done. And they get it done in impressive fashion. Again, coach, not a whole lot to say. Just domination throughout for Lake Wales. They deserve it, and they had a nice team effort again today.
Yeah, it was all came together again. You know, like they're just pure balance. It ran together very well. You just tell that they had just a wonderful chemistry just from playing together this year. You know, nobody had any sort of like, you know, it's about me sort of thing. So just they're a fun team to watch. You know, I just really don't have the adjectives right now to describe, but they just good, solid team, top to bottom. They knew what they wanted to do, and they did it, and they played that way. So just a phenomenal way to end the season, to just go out and know that we are clearly the best.
Well, it was a 21-point lead at the half and a 36-point lead at the end. Congratulations to Lake Wales Highlanders at 28-4. They are state champs. And also congratulations to Terry Parker. They make it to the state championship game. They finish at 25-6. But Lake Wales, the 5A state champs, our final 66-30 again for a DVD of this game or any game of the 2012 FHSAA boys basketball finals. Go to FHSASports.com. It makes a great gift for family, friends of the team, or even team members themselves. That's FHSASports.com. For our entire crew here at the Lakeland Center and for the coach, Will White, I'm Marty Palmer saying so long. This has been a production of Play On Sports on the FHSAA Network. Our final once again in the 5A championship game, the Lake Wales Highlanders 66, the Jacksonville Terry Parker Braves 30. Stay tuned now for the awards ceremony. We'll talk to you again at 1:35, the 6A championship, Leesburg and Miami. Northern Mike Rowland and Will White on the call. Goodbye for now.
We can get a player up here.
Oh, that's good stuff.
All right, perfect. Prepare a Wiley Ballard graphic.
Do you want me to start the stream?
Start the stream. Camera 3. Beautiful. Oh, we're coming in on 1.
For more information on how your school can join the Play On School broadcast program and participate in the FHSAA network, go to FHSAASports.com/SBP.
Three.